I want to bring in Chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, Congressman Jim Jordan. Thank you for joining us today. What a day, Congressman, because we were watching for hours, waiting to see what he would say about that report. A really key moment. He said that he did not exonerate Biden, Congressman, but he did decline to bring any charges because he didn't believe he could actually secure a conviction based on what he saw. He couldn't prove the intent, not just because of his age or his memory, but you took issue with that. Why?
Well, I think what the special counsel said was that he willfully retained classified information and then disclosed classified information to people who weren't allowed to get it. And I mean, this is a guy who's been in office for, you know, close to 50 years, five decades, chaired the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. When he was vice president, he gets a daily intelligence brief. This is a guy who knows the law and knows the rules, and yet he violated those. And so for me, the key question, I raise this in my question, is why would he do that? What would motivate a guy to do that? And Robert Hur told us that. He said he had strong motivations to ignore, and this is Robert Hur's words, not mine, to ignore the procedures around classified documents because he was writing a book and he wanted that information readily available to give to the ghostwriter who wasn't cleared to get it. And why would he want to do all that? $8 million. 8 million reasons he had. So that's the point I think was the most telling, because I always want to know what's the motive for someone who knows the rules to then violate the rules, which is exactly what President Biden did. But of
course, Congressman, on that point, I want to point out one thing, though, and I remember that moment because I think your phrase was he has 8 million reasons to do so, alluding to his book advance. But if you go down to that part of the report, he continues on that he did not feel that he had the evidence that jurors might have been convinced beyond a reasonable doubt that that was enough to prove that it was willful, that the intent was there, and there could have been some innocent explanations.
Well, I'll tell you, I mean, one of the, I think, big pieces of evidence is what the book ghostwriter who had the audio recording of that interview with President Biden, what he did with that information once he found out Robert Hur was named special counsel. What did this guy do? He deleted that information. He tried to destroy evidence. If that's not obstruction, I don't know what is. And I think that goes to motive as well. This ghostwriter knew that there was something, you know, something wrong here. So I think that's a contributing factor in this this whole scenario as well.
I did think it was, when you mentioned the idea of the ghostwriter sliding things into, I think, a recycling bin is what he mentioned. But on that point, if I go back to the report, and that seemed to be where Hur was really focused on, not wanting to go beyond the scope of it, he recognized that there was evidence that some jurors might have deemed as willfully retaining documents, maybe even the motivations you describe. But the idea of the burden of proof was really the biggest part of all of this. But there was a fixation, it seemed, on the idea of Biden's mental acuity or his memory. I found that striking because you saw some of your colleagues on the other side of the aisle pointing out that Trump also shares some memory lapses. He also does make mistakes. Do you concede that both have a similar issue?
Oh, come on. Come on. I mean, everyone makes mistakes in life. I mean, we're human beings, for goodness sake. But there is no way you can say President Trump, he's as sharp as they come. His memory is as strong. I was just with him over the weekend. I know what, and the American people can see it for themselves. They've seen these examples of President Biden forgetting things. I mean, all kinds of examples that we actually played the press conference that President Biden gave in response to when Mr. Hur's report came out and showed that where it, you know, again, I think it was maybe one of the worst press conferences I've ever seen. So to say there's a comparison there made no sense. I thought that what the Democrats did was actually just strange. They were taking snippets here and there, much different than what the American people see on a daily basis from our president. And look, I take no satisfaction in saying that. He's the President Biden's the president of our country. You want our president to have his full faculties, but he obviously doesn't, and the country knows it. And it doesn't matter how many times Democrats say something different, the country can see for themselves and they understand it. And that is something that Mr. Hur pointed out. He said, Joe Biden is a forgetful old man, and that is one of the reasons, key reasons, that I didn't bring charges. And it's why we've asked for the actual audio tapes, not just of Joe Biden's interviews, but all the witnesses Mr. Hur talked to. And we'll see if the Biden administration and the Justice Department turn those over to us. I think they should, so we can evaluate that, the United States Congress, and more importantly, the American people.
Well, I am eager to see how far you're willing to ask for those requests, the audio transcripts as well. But back to this point, because as you have offered that Biden has made mistakes, and certainly, objectively, there are mistakes made, and there have been statements that are known as the gaffes and beyond, but there was also a montage played of Donald Trump doing something, talking about not knowing the dates of his marriage, confusing the names of world leaders. I wonder why, if the notion is that there is a double standard being placed on Donald Trump, isn't it true that there's also a double standard then for President Biden with respect to his mistakes? Why should the American people credit one versus the other if both make similar mistakes that have been played in that actual hearing?
Laura, come on. Come on. I mean, there are three people who've run for president the last three cycles. Secretary Clinton, President Biden, and President Trump. All three have been accused of mishandling classified information. Mm-hmm. Only one is getting prosecuted. Hillary Clinton took a hammer to cell phones, took bleach bit to laptops and computers. I mean, you got to be kidding me. The idea that there's not a double standard and the Justice Department isn't going after President Trump, I think is laughable to disagree with that. Anybody can see it. First it was they spied on his campaign, then it was the special counsel, $30 million, 19 lawyers, 40 FBI agents, Mueller's special counsel, they found nothing. Then it was impeachment, then it was raid his home, then it was Jack Smith's special counsel, then it was the 14th Amendment, which was bogus. If you don't believe me, just look what the Supreme Court said, 9-0. I mean, and now it's this latest, I mean, come on, of course. There's a double standard, and anybody with common sense can see it. And I think that's one of the key reasons why President Trump is ahead in every single poll, and Joe Biden's approval numbers are at, what, 35%?
I certainly think if you look broadly at the system of justice in this country, there are issues with a two-tiered justice system, obviously for the wealthy and those who do not have the means. But I want to narrow your focus, Congressman, away from the broad and to what Herr was focused on instead, because he did respond to this idea that there was a distinction and huge distinctions between the behavior of Trump in the handling of documents and that of Biden, specifically in what happened after the request to return those documents. And frankly, the distinctions he believes is maybe what led to the prosecution of Trump and not Biden. I mean, why, if do you really think that if Trump had returned the documents, had not doubled down, had cooperated, had not had this year and a half expanse between the first request and then, of course, the appointment of special counsel, that he would also still be charged?
I don't think it would have mattered what President Trump did. I think it. I think Jack Smith was going to go. I think the fact that Merrick Garland picked Jack Smith, the same guy who was looking for ways to go after the very people that Lois Lerner and the IRS targeted 15 years ago, conservative Tea Party people around the country. I think the fact that he picked Jack Smith just changed everything. He was going to go after President Trump no matter what he did. I mean, I just think that's, and then, of course, I just think that's the case. And because we've seen it time and time again, that whole litany of examples where they've used this lawfare, this weaponization of government to go after President Trump. But Laura, today wasn't about President Trump. Today was about Robert Herr's examination of Joe Biden. And we laid out the facts there, and Robert Herr laid out the facts. That's what we, when Jack Smith completes this, when that's all over, I'll come over and talk about that. But I know Jack Smith's been out to get President Trump from the get-go, and I actually think that's why the Justice Department, Merrick Garland, selected him.
But you brought up the former President Donald Trump as part of the double standard, and there's also great explanation and pains from this report.
No, you brought up the fact that Democrats brought up President Trump, and that's why I gave that. Three people ran for president: Secretary Clinton, President Biden, President Trump. Only one's been, they've all been accused of mishandling classified documents, but only one of them is getting prosecuted.
And the American people see that. I do hear you. Let's not do the chicken and the egg dance for a second of which came first. Trump was raised today as part of the conversation. Noted. Trump was raised today in front of the hearing, as was some comparisons that were made from others. Hillary Clinton is a favorite as well. Of course, the documents that she was reported to have, James Comey, as we know, addressed those as carelessly maintained, but chose not to pursue prosecution with the U.S. Attorney and, of course, the Attorney General for various reasons. But I want to focus again on this double standard, Congressman, because there is a distinction between the behavior post-recognition of the possession of documents. And so the behavior of Biden to speak with the investigators, to hand over documents and beyond, is very different than what the former President Donald Trump did. Does that not factor in at all for you, that there are key distinctions in how one doubled down and the other cooperated? That doesn't matter at all?
The double standard is, you said it, careless behavior. That's how you said former FBI Director Comey characterized Secretary Clinton. Careless behavior, I'm not going to prosecute. With Joe Biden, it was, oh, he's a forgetful old man who might appear sympathetic to a jury. I'm not going to prosecute, even though he retained information and disclosed it to someone who wasn't allowed to get it. I'm not going to prosecute. But with President Trump, we're going to go after him because we don't think he cooperated enough. That's the allegation. That hasn't been proven. We got the final report from Robert Hur, and we know what took place there. There is definitely a double standard, and it goes against. And here's the other thing. This is the Justice Department prosecuting the president's political opponent. Joe Biden's Justice Department is going after the guy he's running against for president of the United States. That, to me, is also critically important, and I think the American people evaluate it that way as well.